We laughed and cried and reminisced as only siblings can through the early hours of the morning. Stole a pile of biscuits from the kitchen after Nana's snores came drifting down the hall. For a short time, we were kids again. That night remains a precious one in my memory. Suppose it always will. Did see my sister again. Never found out what happened to her and the others, where their journey met its end. She'd been so bitter after that fateful night all those years ago. She had lost something inside herself, and the pain of it all had slowly consumed her. In some ways, Isla had died long before she left Pyreside that morning. I hope the stars granted her a peaceful afterlife among them. I should like to see her there someday. So many things left unsaid. At first I thought it was some odd joke. Laughed aloud even. I'd known Thomas more than a few years by then, but our exchanges were always brief and hardly romantic in nature. Maybe that's how things work out in the wider world, but we Pyreside folk typically get to know someone before declaring our love for them. I told him I needed the night to think it over. Had plenty on my plate those days. With Nana gone to rest, the sleepy dragon was mine to manage. Kelsey helped when she could, stars bless her, but that left meals to cook, floors to sweep, blankets to wash, and all sorts of unruly adventurers to wait upon. Growing up, I was the little sister, the shy one among the village kids. Before Hazel, I never had anyone looking up to me. The constant question in her eyes, the way she'd glance for my approval in moments of doubt, it was exhilarating and terrifying. When someone hangs on your every word, well, you owe it to them to choose those words carefully. I've never known how to feel about gravestones, memories of loved ones, of Mom, Dad, Nana, Isla. In my mind, they're full of life and warmth and colour. Everything a cold, grey rock in the ground could never be. Still, it was nice having a place to go where the world was quiet and my thoughts could belong to them alone.
Well,
minutes.
Thank you.
Perhaps it was foolish holding on to sentiment like that. Selfish, even. But the apothecary held a piece of my childhood. The lingering scent of Imelda's fragrance oils, colourful little jars Joseph had meticulously labelled and set on display so many years ago. I wasn't ready to sell it all away.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.